today we start on the final eight gates of Netzach, the completion of Netzach. And these all focus around the path of Samech, of Sagittarius, from Netzach down, from Yesod down to Netzach, okay? So, this is a very complex path, as are all of these final paths on the Tree of Life. They become more and more complex as we descend the tree. So, there's a lot going on here. This is the final fire sign, zodiacal path in the Tree of Life. Now, all of the fire signs are similar, just like all of the earth signs are similar, all of the air signs are similar, all of the water signs are similar. They play a similar role, just at different levels. So, we had He up top, which was Aries, from Kether to Chokmah. And this brought the Kethric brilliance and essential meaning and the unity of parts, okay? Then we had the mental fire, the mental light coming from Tiferet down to Gedulah, the path of Leo, where we brought the best of the solitary self, that mental light, to Gedulah and the collective of awarenesses. Okay? And then we have the path of Samech down here from Yesod to Netzach. This brings the astral light. Okay, that's a really complex statement, and I'll explain in a moment. Brings the astral light, and it brings not a collective awareness, but a connected group of sentient selves, a connected group of separate individuals who are all connected through resonance, right? And this brings significance. Excuse me. Up here, Tiferet to Gedulah brought subjective meaning. Kether to Chokmah brought essential meaning. Okay, so we have these three different manifestations of the same thing. Subjective meaning is essential meaning at a lower level, at the mental level of solitary selves. Significance is essential meaning at this astral level of sentient selves. So each path brings the same thing, but at a different level. Okay, now, the astral light. This is essentially what we call the vital energy, which fills Netzach. This occurs on this path of Samech, of Sagittarius. Okay. Significance, this interaction between self and other, is so energetic. It's captivating. It's energetic. There is a give and take of energy, and it's dynamic. This is the vital energy, this aliveness that we all feel, that everything feels, this aliveness, this energetic friction that occurs in this interaction between self and other, that opening and closing. That is the vital energy, the astral light. This is the energy of the astral realm. Okay? And that is the primary experience of the astral realm for the human being, is this energy that takes over your body. Okay? That occurs right here. And at the same time, with this interaction between self and other, all of the sentient selves are connected. They're all interacting with each other. The whole of existence is this interaction between self and other, in which all of us are connected to each other. So it is a connected grouping of sentient selves. Now, we all connected to each other in this way have the senses to perceive the state of everything else. It's on this basis that we interact with each other. We are able to perceive the significance of how everything is being affected by everything else. And we perceive in ourselves the significance that we experience of every other thing. This is the essence of significance, is this perception of other and self. That is the nature of significance. That is how significance arises, is we have the senses as sentient selves to perceive how others are affected, and how we are affected and affect others, etc. Okay? So all of that is packed into this path of Samech. Now, Sagittarius, the image, okay. Samech, the Hebrew word Samech, means a prop, something that holds something else up, that supports something else. So it's a support, a prop. It can also be a cane, a stick, a walking stick. Okay, so there's this sense just in the letter of interaction with other, okay? And Sagittarius, the archer, okay? Now, the archer is pulling his bow, and his arrow inevitably is always on target. And that's because we have these senses to perceive, so we know the target, okay? We perceive what is significant in the moment, in our surroundings. That's Sagittarius. Sagittarius is very perceptive. A Sagittarius is a creature of two halves. This horse part, this animal horse part, and this human part, okay? So again, there's the two parts of the I interacting, becoming one in concert, all interacting with each other, okay? So that's the symbolism of the path itself, and that, of course, is our first gate. So today we have one linear gate, the path of Samhik. We have one triangular gate, one quadrangular gate, and one pentangular gate. So first gate, Samhik. So let's start from the universal perspective. We start in Yesod. As a collective of sentient cells, all of the sentient cells, the whole of the I is present here in Yesod as all of the sentient cells. And collectively, we realize that we are all connected through our interactions with each other. We all sense each other. We all touch and affect each other continuously, affecting and changing and touching each other. And then we rise back up to Yesod, where we simply exist as sentient selves. Okay, so from that, we learn how we become so interactive and how consuming that interaction is. Okay. And so from the personal perspective, we start in Yesod as our sentient selves. Suddenly, it's all about significance and this interaction with other, and we descend into Nessa, where here we feel the whole universe. We interact with it. It affects us and we affect it. And it's all so significant. Every interaction is filled with significance and vital energy. It's all so energetic and captivating, this interaction, the infinite intricacy of this interaction with other. It's always energetic and so significant here in Netzach. And then we rise back up to Yesod, where it's somehow calmer. We are less involved and more just startled by the newness of significance and this ability suddenly to sense everything around us. So here we learn about the evolution of our sensory body. and what the sensory body is for and how it functions in this astral realm of significance, how it guides us, okay? This is where we learn about the astral senses, right here, and the energetic behind each one of those senses. Okay, this is also where we learn about the vital energy and its usage, its functions, okay? And its mastery is right here in this path of Sagittarius. This is where we can master the vital energy, okay? So, the next gate is a triangle, and it goes from Yesod down the path of Samech, Sagittarius, into Netzach, and then up the path of Kaf and Venus into Gedula, okay? And then along the path of Libra from Gedula into Yesod, and then back around. Now, all three of these paths integrate Gedula into Sagittarius. So what it is doing here with this gate is it's bringing the collective nature of Gedula into Netzach and really informing us of how everything is connected through resonance. This power of Netzach brought by Samech, this power of resonance, and what that means in terms of the collectivity of awareness, okay? We are all connected in Netzach through resonance, okay? So that's at both the universal and personal levels. Now, the next gate is the quadrangle. Okay, this gate, as before, begins in Yesod. Takes Samech, Sagittarius, down to Netzach. Kaf, Libra, up to Gedula, and then Leo, Teth, up to Tiferet, and then Resh, Sun, down to Yesod, and then back around. Now, what this does is, of course, integrate Tiferet into this dynamic between Gedula and Yesod meeting in Netzach, between Samech, Sagittarius, Venus. And now Leo and the Sun are involved in this, in the solitary self. And it informs us the role that the solitary self plays in this process of resonance. We have limits to our ability to resonate. And that comes from the solitary self, that particular set of essential meanings that we must express, and we express them through our resonance, okay? Now, the final path is a pentangle. So, it begins from Yesod down the path of Samech to Netzach, up the path of Venus to get Jula, and then up the hidden path to Kether. Then down the path of Vav and Taurus to Bina, and then down the hidden path all the way back to Yesod, okay? And then, of course, back around. Okay. Now, this obviously brings Kether and, to a certain extent, Bina into the equation. It brings a supernal realm into the equation in a slightly different way than this connection with Tiferet did. It focuses on the essential meaning, that quantity of essential meaning that we inherit, basically, that we manifest, that we express. But it's referencing it to Kether and Bina. Okay? And really, the critical parts of this gate are that the hidden path rise up to Kether and the hidden path descent from Bina. Okay? Those are the most important parts of this gate. So, that's it for today. Next time will be the final four gates of Sonic. Okay, bye-bye.